So we're going to start with looking at repetition. So kill and drill became a popular mantra for a reason. Most of us did repetition wrong. So the first thing is that repetition has to be varied. So what in the world could repetition be if it's varied? I'll give you a great example. We're celebrating the 50th anniversary of it this year. Martin Luther King in August 1963 gave a speech known as what? I Have a Dream. Why is it known as the I Have a Dream speech? Because he repeated it 8 times and every sentence ended differently. That's repetition with variation. And because he did it, we remember the speech by his repetition with variation. You want kids to remember, you vary the drill. You want to kill them, you keep the drill the same. So there's more to it. You do interval training in athletics because intense drill develops muscles faster than sloppy drill. But you can only do it for a brief moment in time. So 10 minutes a day over 5 days works better than 40 minutes at once. So there are other things, spacing, duration, frequency. Does it allow the student to go slow at first before they speed up? And then last, because we want to develop sustained motivation, is the self-assessment frequent enough? Okay, so if you have to learn in a zone that is hard, how can you stick with it? Will you like the learning? Probably not. It's hard. But you know what's interesting about our brains? We remember based what happened at the end. If at the end of the learning increment we mastered it, we think the whole thing was fun. And we do it again. And we do it again. And we keep doing it. You skip assessment that's internal to the student, you don't feed them. You've got to feed them, it's got to be frequent, and it's got to be internal.